Here we're going to talk about solving equations that are quadratic in form. So first of all, do you remember what we mean by a quadratic equation? Well, that's one where simply the variable has been squared. So for example, generally speaking, it'll look like this. Ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, right? Where a, b, and c are our real numbers. Now, when we talk about an equation that's quadratic in form, all we mean is that the equation has the following form. You have A times, let's write this as something squared plus B times the same something plus C is equal to 0. Now, what's the something? It can be lots of different things. It could be, for example, x plus 3 in parentheses. Now, what's important is that you have that x plus 3 in parentheses over here as well. So it's x plus 3 in parentheses, and notice how that's being squared, right? Because this 2 is inherited from that 2. Another example, you could have, instead of x plus 3, you could have something like this, like z to the negative first. In parentheses. Now, of course, you need that same thing over here, z to the negative first, and then that being squared. Or you could even have something like this, like how about y to the 1/3? Well, if you have y to the 1/3 over here, and that's being squared, then in all three of these cases, we call these quadratic in form. So what's important is that you have something and then the same something squared. So again, something, the same something squared, and then finally something and the same something squared. Now the reason that's important, the reason that this form is important, is because in all three cases, these equations could be recast as a quadratic equation that we can solve. Okay, let's see how that's done now. Let's say we want to solve x minus 5 squared minus 4 times x minus 5 minus 21 is equal to 0. Okay, so first of all, do you see how we have something and then that same something squared? Sure, right? I have x minus 5, and then over here, x minus 5, the same something, squared. Okay, when you notice that, you have that, we make the following substitution. We're going to replace the something, that in this case, the x minus 5, with another variable. So I'm going to choose w. So w is going to be x minus 5. Now you could pick another letter if you want. You could pick y or z, but you just want to make sure that it's something that's not going to confuse you. In other words, you don't want to pick an x here because x is already being used. So I'm choosing a w. X minus 5 is equal to w. Now what that means is that everywhere I see an x minus 5, I'm going to replace it with w. So x minus 5, oh, that's going to be w squared. And the squared here is from that 2 there, right? And then minus 4, okay, here's another x minus 5. Replace that with a w. And then finally, minus 21 is equal to 0. So when we do that, that gives rise to a quadratic equation. So that's why the original equation was called quadratic in form, because with an appropriate substitution, it can be written as a quadratic. Now, it's true that if you take the original equation and you expand it out, this indeed is a quadratic equation. So it's not that equations that are quadratic in form are not quadratic. It's just that they can be written in a simpler form with an appropriate substitution. Okay, so sometimes the originals are quadratic, but we're going to see ones later on where the originals are not quadratic. In both cases, though, they can be recast as equations that are quadratic that are easier to work with in that new form. Okay, so we can solve this equation, right? And I can do it. Well, it's a quadratic equation, and I can either try to factor the left-hand side or use the quadratic formula. Well, factoring is easy in this case. It's going to be w minus 7 times w plus 3 is equal to 0. So then I set each of these equal to 0. So w is going to be either 7, right, when I set this one to 0, or I get w is equal to negative 3. Okay, now the final step would be to back substitute, that is, replace w with what it is, which is x minus 5. So x minus 5 is equal to 7. That is, I replaced w with x minus 5 again. Or x minus 5 is equal to negative 3. Add 5 to both sides, so x is equal to 12. Or add 5 to both sides here and you get x is equal to 2. Now the reason, these would be our answers, and the reason we had to back substitute is because, you know, these aren't our solutions, right? We're not asked to find values of w. We were asked to find values of x. So we had to back substitute to get our final solutions. Okay, and that's how these problems are going to go. You're going to look for something such that you also have that something squared. You're going to create a quadratic equation. We're going to solve it, and then we're going to back substitute to get the original variable and our solutions. Okay, let's go ahead and take another example. Okay, let's solve x to the fourth minus 14x squared minus 32 is equal to 0. So looking at this problem, do you see something and then something squared? Well, sure, right? Because x to the fourth, that is x squared squared, right? That's x to the fourth. So what that's telling you is that x squared is your something, because if you take that something and you square it, you get x to the fourth. That is, we can write it like this. X to the fourth is x squared squared. And then minus 14x squared minus 32 is equal to 0. So what that means is we're going to replace the x squared with w. Remember, we want to replace the something with w. This is going to be our substitution. So everywhere you see an x squared, replace it with w. Here's an x squared, so it's going to be w squared. And this 2 came from that 2 right there. Minus 14, let's see, x squared is w. Minus 32 is equal to 0. And now this is a quadratic equation that can be factored. So it's going to be w minus 16 times w plus 2 is equal to 0. And now we're going to set each of those equal to 0. And the first one's going to give w is equal to 16. And then or, well, w is equal to negative 2. Let me write that as a negative 2 so you can see that clearly. Okay, now the final step is replace w with the original variable, right? That is, well, not w is not equal to simply x, but w is equal to x squared. So you want to replace w with the expression containing the original variable. So here we go, x squared is equal to 16, right? Or x squared is equal to negative 2, because that's what w is, it's x squared. Okay, now we can use the square root property on both of these. So we get x equals plus or minus the square root of 16, or x equals plus or minus the square root of negative 2. And the first one, the square root of 16 is 4, so x equals plus or minus 4. And then or x equals plus or minus. Now the square root of negative 2, when you have the square root of a negative, that gives you I. So it's I square root of 2. And these are our four solutions. Positive 4, negative 4, positive I root 2, and negative I root 2. Notice the original equation was not quadratic. It was a fourth degree polynomial. But we converted it to a quadratic equation because we know how to solve any quadratic equation. We solved that, and then we back substituted to get our solutions to the problem. Okay, let's try one more like that. Let's solve m to the 2 thirds minus 3m to the 1 third is equal to 10. So first of all, you want to look for a connection between the expressions containing the variable. So I look at m to the 2 thirds and I say, how's that connected to m to the 1 third? Well, isn't it true that if you take m to the 1 third and you square it, what do you do with those exponents? That's right, you multiply them. So that would be m to the 2 thirds. And that's important because that's telling you that if you take m to the 1 third and you square it, you get m to the 2 thirds. In other words, m to the 2 thirds can be written as m to the 1/3 squared. Okay, and then minus 3 m to the 1/3. Now let's subtract 10 from both sides, so we get 0 on the right-hand side. And now I'm looking at an equation that's quadratic in form, because they have something and the same something squared. And that means we're going to replace the something with w. So w is going to be m to the 1/3. So everywhere I see an m to the 1/3, replace it with w. So I get w squared minus 3 times w minus 10 is equal to 0. And that's a quadratic equation we can solve. So it's going to be w minus 5 times w plus 2 is equal to 0. So w is either equal to 5, or w is equal to negative 2. Replace the w now with the expression containing the original variable. So m to the 1/3 is equal to 5, or m to the 1/3 is equal to negative 2. Now we're trying to get m by itself. And so this is the cube root of m, right? So I'm going to cube both sides to get that m by itself. So I get m is equal to 125. That's one possibility. And likewise, if I cube m to the 1/3 here, and I cube negative 2, I get m is equal to negative 8. So there's my second solution. So my solutions are either 125 or negative 8. These are both solutions. Okay, so that's how we solve equations that are quadratic in form. We look to make a substitution, solve the resulting quadratic equation, back substitute to find the solutions of the original variable. Okay, until next time.